One, low.
Aggressive serve and an aggressive attempt on the receive from Akula.
That's Akula's signature stroke. Step around forehand attack from her. She's been really clean with that.
Love.
It's a test of patience for Chung Yijing.
For sure, the long pimples from Srija Akula can be so surprising.
Oh, but transferred beautifully. I mean, the technique of Chung Yijing, when I'm watching her, it is just mouth-watering. How efficient and effective her movement is.
Also, the style of play Chung Yijing is not new for her. They played against Srija Akula in the women's doubles here in Goa already. Well, she's also played against Manika Batra many times. Just a very similar style of play, but a very different setup of rallies from both the Indians.
The step around and the pimple feeling shot from Akula. Why is Akula more aggressive than Batra on that step around?
Well, the major difference between Batra and Akula is the ability for Akula to make much more spinny top spins. Batra goes more in for smashes, but Akula is that spinny top spin she's able to make is gives her more room to play better forehand attacks.
Do you think her slightly shorter stature as well makes it easier for her to do it on the step around, on the pivot? Oh, lovely twiddle and then the parallel forehand. That was instinctive from Akula.
And that crowd support is quite something for Akula to really up her spirits. Quite literally, the coach was also up on his chair.
I asked that, Neha, because I see the slightly shorter players who have a naturally slower centre of gravity pivot quicker on average. And I want to know why. What is it about the height that makes players feel like they can do that more?
Just quicker turnaround time, right? It's just simple laws of the land. If you're taller, your limbs are just longer and you'll take a little bit more time versus a shorter heighted player.
Seven.
So better use it to your own advantage.
That might be why we see so many of the taller players like Ovcharov Putsa be backhand orientated.
Yeah, and they need to have that weapon because they will take a bit more time to turn around. But talk about turnaround, that step around from Chung Yijing. Again, something which she really loves to do. So beautiful. Just completely putting Akula off guard.
Yeah, putting her in a place in this first game. Knocking her down a peg or two.
That is what I was talking about. The ability to make more loopy top spins from Srija Akula. Just came back winning the feeder, WTT feeder tournament in Texas, in the US. Very high on confidence currently.
Yeah, as well as that national championship title.
Which was in 2022. Which was again a big year for her. She won the mixed doubles gold in the Commonwealth Games.
Five.
Pairing with the legend Sharad Kamal. She was awarded the Arjuna Award as well by the President of India. But now Chung Yijing with 5 game points.
Yeah, she's been as high as 5 in the world for a reason, Chung Yijing. Can she rise to the occasion?
One.
Certainly did in this first point. That step around forehand attack down the line. It was quite a surprise because generally she hits it cross court.
One.
Changicheng being Changicheng. Talk about that forehand. So big. And the impact also, right? It was so intimidating to at least watch it from here.
One, two.
We tried to sell this, to promote this as something that could be a very close contest, and it could be, but so far it seems like this is going to be a test too tough for Akula. We're going to have to see her, I think, be at her most aggressive and also get a bit of fortune if she wants to stand a chance here. 50% point to win on serve for Jung and only 30 for Akula. She's reading the serve pretty well here and following up with equal might.
Yeah, in the last 3 weeks itself, Akula has won over world number 37, Lily Zhang, Du Hoi Kim, 36, Hannah Goda, 30. But there surely is a huge difference between a top 20 player in the world in Zhang Yijing, who's as high as number 5.
Yeah, back in 2017. Where she got two big medals at the World Cup and World Championships.
Three, four.
I think it's fair to say Akula has established herself as a top 32 player in the world. Might not be too long before she's playing the champions level event.
That'll be great for sport in India.
That
twiddle was very much needed from Akula. Look at how quick she does it, reading the ball well, and that boom, a punch went down the line. No time for Zhang Yijing to react.
Yeah! And a fanning backhand. She's showing a bit of flair here, the Indian.
More vocal as well as the match progresses. Kind of finding her rhythm in now.
Four,
or was it the side?
It was the side, I think. Was it?
I thought she's played it from inside the table, Neha, but maybe it was outside. No dispute, must have been. 4-6, Zhang Yijing coming in with the shovel.
Yeah.
Can't dig her out of trouble.
4-7.
It's so lovely to see Akula displacing somebody as good as Zhang Yijing. Wide on the forehand side. How smart a player Akula is at this point. Also very gutsy to do that at this stage. Yeah.
Pushing it.
4.
On the forehand.
Yeah, it's the alpha mentality that she's bringing here. Akula, gritty.
Yeah, and very smart, really understanding to avoid Zhang Yijing to make that step around forehand spin. So she's starting to pin the rallies from the forehand side.
Yes, yes.
8-5.
What a brilliant soft push from Zhang Yijing. She's too good in the short play. I think the movement, the body movement for Zhang Yijing to get into the ball, which is near the net, is so good. The transfer from the left to right makes her being really dominant when the ball is kept slightly in the middle of the table.
You can see here, Zhang Yijing is freezing slightly because of how much he's getting moved side to side.
And I think if only Srija Akula can get more twiddling in, she can bring in more surprises and use that deep forehand of Zhang Yijing to her advantage.
9-7.
Tried to really rev up the forearm there for a fade, but Zhang Yijing gets away for a slightly loose serve, but at least it had loads of backspin on it.
bit of misread from Jung Ijing, but this won't hurt for the Indian. Now setting up 3 game points for herself.
10-7.
Oh, that banana, but 11, where did that come?
Anything he ever achieved in singles, that's how important this match is for Indian table tennis.
And that turnaround topspin from Srija Akula, similar to what Jung Ijing actually does.
One, all.
She's a grizzled player, Jung Ijing. She's been in so many tight, nail-biting affairs. And it might be that experience that helps her out here against Akula. And that is especially important against the style of the Indians. She even played the long pimples with the forearm there, Akula.
Left.
Well, at that.
Good full service inside the end line, please.
At that level, you need to learn how to do that.
One, two.
A warning from the umpire for Akula to toss the ball straight.
I think it was to do it behind the white line.
Three.
I think she served it maybe in front of it. Tightening the screw here, Jung Ijing. Short backspin to forehand. The switches. Yeah, she took control. She played for position on the table there, Akula.
Well, the world does not know the importance for Srija Akula to be here and try to win this match. She is the only Indian standing here at WTT star contender Goa so far.
Two,
and you can see the entire fan base also rallying behind her.
I mean, Manika Batra getting that bronze at the Asian Cup in Bangkok was absolutely magical. Huge for Indian table tennis. But to win, to actually win a WTT star contender, where basically everyone, just apart from the very top Chinese and Japanese here, would be mind-blowing.
And also Akula really wanting to get in a qualification for herself for Paris Olympics, wants it badly. What a timing for her to be playing so well. That forehand hits the back edge of the table. Akula comes with a nice apology, but a poker face there.
She's such a relaxed person, isn't she?
And her ability to stay calm in the most tense situations is her strength. And I'll tell you her second strength in just some time. Well, that surely is one of hers. Again, step around forehand. I'm so happily amazed how good she is. That 80% forehand shot wins from Akula. When having long pips on the backhand side, it's so important to have this destructive stroke.
Oh, the second one comes back though.
5-6.
Akula has also won a lot of matches, Fraser, from down 3-0. So you can never write her off. She will fight till the end. She's that sort of a mentality player.
Well.
7-5.
Jung Ijing here as well is treating this pressure as a privilege, being out here on table one in this quarterfinal means a lot to her as well, of course. The finalist last year in Goa, losing to Wang Yidi, who isn't here.
5.
And just look at the face. She's so focused and yet so aggressive at the same time.
Oh, you've got to love Jung Ijing. She's a really cool player.
5.
And it seems like she's here on a mission, because when you have the entire crowd against you, could be a very lonely battle too, right?
Yeah, it takes extra sort of gutso to get through.
But well, last 4 points to Jungi Jing. Really, this third game is so crucial for Akula.
Let 5-9. Let 5-9.
Second time let.
Nine.
Yeah, tongue going with it, isn't she?
Going quite steamy there.
Oh, well, that's the thing. If she does twiddle, Jungi Jing's expecting it now, and then Akula can't twiddle back again quick enough. Fast and furious play from Jungi Jing.
Six.
Well,
game to Sheng.
It'll do a world of good confidence for her moving forward.
Love one.
Yeah, she'll be on quite a lot of players' hit list now, won't she, Srijit Akula? It'll be a question of maintaining it.
Two, love.
But when you're up against someone who is an out-and-out aggressive player with inverted rubber on both sides, it seems to be more of a stylistic limitation that Akula has. I think that's fair to say.
Yeah, that backhand.
Low.
Not a fault, no point deducted.
That was long, a lot of backspin in it, that serve. Not the best shot selection from Srijit Akula. A bit of a desperation shot, I felt there. 7 of the last 8 points for Jungi Jing. How dominating she has suddenly been after losing that second game. This is destruction, Fraser.
That was absolutely brilliant, wasn't it? Not only how wide she took it on, but then how wide she made the winner. Pinpoint precision from Jungi Jing.
Six,
just
one.
No answers anymore from Akula there. Jungi Jing is just too strong, and the reason why, she is a top 20 player in the world. Just the quickness of the feet is much better than the Indian.
2-6.
You're slowly seeing less of Akula's forehands that you saw more in the first two games. Yeah, three. More like it. Six. She has to start her attacks with the long pips on the back inside. You can't go more defensive. You have to steal in these forehand attacks. A very well done one from Akula. Oh, brilliant. That twiddle was good, but not as good as Jungi Jing's movement. How quick was she to recover? Brilliant.
Outrageous. I thought Akula had her dead and buried when she twiddled there.
I thought she got the point too.
Let 7-3.
To really go deep in the points to just grab it, earn every single point.
Eight.
It's slipping through the fingers here of Srijit Akula. She has to make a move now.
Beautiful. Two inside out forehand attacks, step around. Man, if you want to learn how to make a good inside-out forehand attack, learn from Zhang Yijing. That shift in the body weight is so clean as well. 6-point lead for Zhang Yijing now.
Oh yeah, she's just been too good.
Ten.
Sometimes you have to hold up your hand and admit it. But it's been the tournament, the event of Shuja Rakula's life.
10.
Yeah,
four.
She can surely be proud of herself. That fortune favors the brave is for her in Goa.
She fought to the 11, last breath there. But it's the Pantheress of Chinese Taipei, Zhang Yijing.